This is going to be part two to the introduction of to exponential functions. So we have this general formula, this general equation, y equals a times b raised to the x over delta x. And I want to take a look at that b and see if there's any problems with that. So I'm just going to write y equals b to the x. And what I want to know is, are there any numbers that b should not be, that I can't put in there? Well, it wouldn't make any sense for b to be zero. Okay, because I wouldn't have much of an equation here. It also wouldn't make sense for b to equal 1. Because if b was 1, any number to the first power is a 1. So it also wouldn't be much of an equation. The other thing is, I want b to be greater than 0. In other words, not only shouldn't it equal 0, but it has to be greater than 0. And here's why. Let's say that b is negative 2. Okay, well, when b is negative 2, and I've got an even exponent, like a 2 or a 4 or a 6, I'm going to have a positive result. If b is negative 2 and I've got an odd exponent, like 1 or 3 or 5, I've got a negative result. So this thing would bounce all over the place. It's just not going to work, and certainly not going to work if I have rational exponents. Okay, so my restrictions on b are that b has to be greater than 1. B has to not equal 1, and it has to be greater than 0. Okay, so let's look at an example. Okay, so here's my general formula once again. You've probably got that memorized by now. Be a good idea to memorize it. And I've got my table of values in my input column. I've got 0, 3, 6, and 9. So it looks like there's a common difference. It looks like I'm jumping up by 3s each time. 0 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 9. So if the common difference, if the change is 3, that means I can just write down that delta x is going to equal 3. Let's look at the output column, 200, 100, 50, and 25. Well, these numbers decrease in value. I haven't seen that before. But let's go ahead and see what we can make of it. So I'll take these first two numbers, 200 and 100, and I'll find the common ratio. I'll form a fraction with the number lower down on the list as the numerator, and the number just above it on the list as the denominator, 100 over 200. And I can reduce that to 1/2. I'll take the next pair of numbers, 100 and 50. So that means my fraction is going to be 50 over the number just above the 50, which is 100. And that'll be 1/2. And then if I take the third pair of numbers, 50 and 25, I want 25 as my numerator, 50 is my denominator, and 50 over 25 equals 1/2. So b is 1/2. So let's write what we have so far. Y equals a, I don't know what a is yet, times the fraction 1/2 raised to the x over delta x. Well, delta x is 3. And now let's see if I can figure out what a has to be. So I'll go back to this pair, 0 and 200. So when y is 200, I'm going to have a times b, my b is my common ratio, 1/2. I'm going to raise that to x is 0. The 0 over 3 power. Well, 0 over 3 is 0. Any number, like 1/2, raised to the 0 power is 1. So this thing is the same as 200 equals a times 1, or just a. So a must be 200. Okay, let's put that in and check it with some other numbers. So y equals 200 times the fraction 1/2 raised to the x over 3. That should be my specific formula, my specific equation. Let's try it with 3 and 100. So 100 equals 200 times 1/2 raised to the 3 over 3. 3 over 3 is 1. 1/2 of times 200 is 100. So that works. We'll do one more pair. I've got a 6 and a 50. So when I've got a 50 as the y, I'll have 200 equal 50 equals 200 times 1 half to the 6 over 3. 6 over 3 is the same as 2. 50 equals 200 times 1 half squared. So 50 equals 200 times, well, I've got to take this 1 half and square it. 1 raised to the second power is still just 1, and 2 raised to the second power is 4. So that's going to be 200 times 1 quarter, and 1 quarter of 200 is 50. So this equation, y equals 200 times 1 half raised to the x over 3, will be the specific formula, the specific equation for this table of values. Okay? One more point I want to make. Actually, two more points. First of all, could the a have been any number at all? Could the a have been 0? Well, that wouldn't make any sense at all. So we don't want a to be 0. Could the a have been negative? Well, I guess, why not? If a was negative, let's say a was negative 200, all of these numbers in my output column would have just been negative. That's fine. If a had been a fraction, the numbers would have been smaller, but that would be fine. So a can be any number at all, but it really wouldn't make much sense for a to be 0. Okay? Okay, one more point I want to make. Here I've got a table of values again, 20, 25, 30, 35, and that was my input column. My output column is 16, 32, 64, 128. So let's look at this. 20, 25, 30, 35, I'm counting by fives. So I'm changing, my change in x is 5, so delta x equals 5. Let's look at the numbers, 16, the y column, 16 to 32, 32 to 64. It looks like I'm doubling them. And we can check that to be sure. I'll see what the ratio is of 32 over 16. 32 over 16 is 2. 64 over 32 is 2. And 128 over 64 is 2. So my ratio is 2. My B is 2. I know what my delta X is. So let's write y equals a, that's the part I still don't know, times 2 raised to the x over delta x, which is 5. Now, previously, we've always had a 0 in the input column, and that's been kind of nice because then we know that anything to the 0 power is 1. We don't have a 0 here. So let's see if we can still figure this out, starting with a different x value. So I'm going to take the pair 20 for x and 16 for y. So let's see. When y is 16, I'm going to have a times 2 to the, x is 20, 20 over delta x is 5. That means I'll have 16 equals a times 2, 20 over 5 is 4, and 2 to the 4th is 16, 2, 4, 8, 16. So 16 equals a times 16. Oh, so that should mean if I divide both sides by 16, a should just equal 1. That's nice. That can happen. Let's check that out and make sure. So if a is 1, I'll put the 1 in there just to be safe. When y is 32, I've got this pair 25 and 32. When y is 32, I should have 1 times 2 to the, x is 25, 5, 25 over 5. 25 over 5 is 5. 32 equals 1 times 2 to the fifth. 2 to the fifth is 32. 1 times 32 is 32. Okay? So this works out fine. In other words, the point I wanted to make is you don't have to worry if you're not starting out with a zero in the input column. Okay? You can use the same approach we used for any pair of numbers to find out what your A equals. Okay, so I'm running over time. That's about it. I'll see you next time.